values as being those things that are most important priorities. And the word value is very sort of ambiguous, so we're very practical about the way we define it. We have written about values in terms of groups and individual development, and we focus mostly on how to develop one's personal self. We worked a lot in the past with leadership and executive development, and we found that that begins with learning about yourself. For us, there are no values that are more important than others. All values are of equal importance. The question is, what do you do with them? How does it work for you? So that's, we're going to talk about that.
We're also very grateful to be here. And the work that you're doing and the efforts that you're doing to understand each other across cultures has a very great deal to do with values. So we'll talk a little bit more after we do an exercise. But one of the things, we won't be showing a show because our device is incompatible. But we value flexibility. And we've had a reason to prioritize that value very highly over a long career of working in a lot of different kinds of organizations, with small groups, large groups, in businesses, large industries, small not-for-profit groups, in all different kinds of enterprise, all different kinds of fields of business, all different kinds of enterprise with regard to not-for-profit and personal self-development. We've worked for 20, 30 years to help develop leaders, particularly, most of our work has been concentrated so far in North America and in Europe, but we'd like to do something practical with you first. So what we're handing out are five, each of you will receive five identical cards, and if you would not mind taking a set of those five cards and handing them on to the next person to you. There are a couple of things I'm going to ask you to do. What you see are, you should each have a card for the value of honesty, for the value of reconciliation, for the value of strategy, for the value of responsibility, and for the value of trust. And what we would like you to do is, first, on your own, we would like you to rank order these cards for yourself, as yourself. Who am I in the world? What's important to me?
What do you think is most important? Put that one on top.
Yes. So if you would, please rank order these in importance to you for whatever reason you wish to order them in that way, so that the most important will be on the top and the least important will be on the bottom in order of, say, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Most important on the top, ranking down in order to least important on the bottom. So have a conversation with one other person.
So find a partner. I think there are odd number of people against the wall here, so if somebody will have to move over.
Or maybe so please take about 5 minutes, to have a conversation with another person. If you need to move to this,
I'm glad to see that you all got the right answer. That's the most important thing. Of course, this is not a test, but it's interesting. What did you notice? Would you notice it? Yeah.
That each one has an argument to their decision.
Excellent. Everybody has an argument to their decision. Everyone can do, we all do what we do because we think we're right. Everyone thinks, well, my values are correct. That's why I took them where I did. And everybody, did anyone see that anybody's values are the same as theirs? Their order was the same? Not really. That's unusual, actually. Yeah. That's interesting. Any other comments or insights?
What else did you see? What else did you hear?
But the way she thought about it, like in an inside way, while I was thinking more like in others and outside ways, so that it was the first her first choice, and I was like, was waiting for my response, and I was like thinking about, wow, and then I thought,
exactly, yes. Yes, values are very ambiguous, so everybody has a little bit of a different idea about what this word means. But we all use the same words. We all use the word like honesty, or in another language, the equivalent of that. But we have the concept. But everybody defines it a little bit differently, and that's very important. And can lead to misunderstandings very easily. Any other insights? Yes, please.
We also were talking, and we realized that maybe it's not about what is more important, because we realize that maybe it's just a circle, because trust depends on honesty and honesty depends on other things and stuff, so we decide that maybe it's just a circle, not a line.
Exactly, exactly. That's really important. You want to say something?
Yes, values connect. We don't hold values in isolation. They undermine each other, they support each other, they go sideways to each other, and they change their meanings. Values change meaning. Clustered with other values, so you described that as well. What else did you see?
Yes. Well, we have very different orders, but for reasonings, we're more or less similar.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Even having different orders, the reasoning for that order were more or less the same.
Interesting, yes. Yes. Okay. Anything else? Did anyone happen to notice how noisy it was?
Yeah.
One of the things we like to do with this exercise is it's a way of showing in experientially a lot of different things about how values operate. There are a lot of theories about values. There's been a lot of discussion about values historically. So we believe values are energy. Energy that moves us, energy that moves us towards things that we want to do, towards ideas that we want to get close to, things that we want to express. This energy moves us towards other people and institutions that we feel the same, think the same, hold the same values that we do. Values also cause us to feel repelled from people who we don't think share our values, from institutions who don't think share our values.
When we talk about values, it's very important to recognize that everyone has this source of energy. And so we do it with a great deal of respect and sensitivity and care. In order to have a discussion about what you think is important or what you think is important, and recognizing that there will be differences, we have to create safety. We have to create psychological safety to recognize that differences are okay. In fact, differences are good, because diversity, people see the problems differently, they solve problems differently, and they're resources. They help us understand the same issue, but maybe in a different way to help us be creative.
In the short time we have with you this evening, there are a few things that we'd like for you to take away that we hope will be useful for you. One, we've mentioned that we believe that values are energy, and we see that expressed in how we feel attracted to people, institutions, and things and ideas, and how we feel repulsed. So the energy is a big driver, and if we understand it that way, it's a little bit easier to get outside of theoretical differences. Energy is a human quality. We all have it. We all have a certain amount of it to spend. And if we think of how we align or disalign or can come back into alignment with people with regard to energy, it's a little easier to think about. It's a little easier to think about, how am I being impacted by the values I'm holding? How am I being impacted energetically if I decide to change my values for a compelling reason? How am I impacting other people when I approach them with a values proposition that they may or may not feel aligned with? Watch for the energy. We also understand that values are choices. Many of us come to live with a set of values that we've gotten from childhood, we've gotten from our cultures, from our institutions, and those will be different. There are a lot of national differences that have been measured with regard to values. However, within any national culture, there is an individual continuum of people who have different values, preferences for different reasons. So even if we choose to, there's a lot of great research about cultural values. And we want to remember that individuals are the people who hold values. Within a culture, no matter what the culture, what kind of cultural pressures it places or opportunities it creates, each one of us individually walks around as a different personal cloud of values. So it's a good thing to remember that we're all unique in that regard. We may be greatly influenced by our culture, and we also can make values as choices.
There are thousands of human values, thousands. We have a survey, an assessment instrument. It's online. People take it and get a little report. And so we work with 102 common values. We gave you five of common values. But if you don't see your particular values represented, don't worry. Because there are so many different values. But values, they shift, they begin to change, and they cluster. So if you have a value like honesty, for example, and a value like independence, it looks different in somebody's behavior if they have honesty and maybe community. Those two different people will have honesty together, but they might look at each other and not understand each other until they sit down and have a little discussion, like the one you just had with someone else. And when we're at work with somebody, on the same team, or maybe in the same organization, or maybe we meet them in socially, we might recognize that we have some of the same values, some of the things we hold as important, but we might not understand what else is going on with them until we find out that, oh, this person is a community person, and I'm much more of an independent person, or this person is much more socially oriented, and I'm more internally oriented. And those kinds of linkings, clusters, they begin to change our values very subtly and slightly. So we end up with an entirely different person.
So one of the things you may have noticed, I think some of you did, is that we handed you cards that have a definition on them. But did you stick to that definition in your conversations?
No.
No? How quickly did you depart from that definition? Pretty fast, probably. We all define our values differently, which means that one of the reasons we do is that we may hold a value of honesty, we may hold a value of strategy and put those together, but then if we put a different value together, it looks different. So honesty and community, for example, looks very different from honesty and strategy. So we also have the opportunity to prioritize our values differently in different contexts. That honesty value may need to recede a little bit if community needs to come up with regard to however we interpret it. But we also need to know that because we all define our values differently, the only way that we can know, first of all, how we define our values is to reflect on it and think about it, bring them into consciousness. Also, the only way we know what anybody else values is to have a dialogue. So one of the things that we would like for you to be able to take away is even though values can be measured, and it's very interesting and it's very useful, we also need to, that information is only so useful, there's a limit. And it's limited by the degree to which we're able to converse with each other and to understand how we individually define those values, how we individually prioritize them, how much we care about them, and what they mean to us uniquely. So those are the things that we would really like for you to carry away. In addition to those cards, do you envision yourself ever having a conversation with someone else, perhaps using those cards? Would anybody like ever see themselves doing something like that? If you do, feel free to do that. Feel free to use this as a tool if you wish. It's something you actually could replicate this kind of conversation with. Did you learn something different about the people that you spoke to using these cards today?
Any surprises? Good.
I completely agree about energy. The energy has to do with Rumi. But as you say, values are held in very different ways and of course cultural context. And to say that you have values does not necessarily mean those are good values, right? So the word value in itself does not, because somehow it's being overused or misused, but no, I mean, when we talk about values, if we compare, for example, I don't know, we have in, what's the limit, you know? I mean, they are energy, okay?
Values drive behavior. We are motivated. We behave based on our values. But they are not behavior. So behavior and values are two different things. They're linked together, but one value can represent many different behaviors. So, and so what we're asking for people to identify is what they think is important. We don't know how well they do it. So this is not a behavioral assessment. So somebody who we think is a terrorist, for example, if we ask them what was important, they might say safety, security, belief. So from their position, they might choose the same values we do, but we think their behaviors are destructive. So how do we have a dialogue so that we can communicate with people and solve the problems that we see in society? Well, we have to create a special environment, and we have to say, as long as we talk, we're not going to judge each other. We're going to listen to each other. We're going to listen for comprehension first, and we listen for evaluation second, instead of evaluating and judging first and then comprehending second. So we separate them out. And that's the only way to proceed and be able to use this effectively. It's difficult. It takes a lot of energy. And we have to make a commitment that we're going to do that. So we have to put our own judgment, or we have to put our own values on hold so that we don't judge for a little while. And then when we go home, okay, you can make your judgment.
Yeah, this is not an easy proposition. But what we're asking is to find new ways to dialogue. And that values can be something that we can come together on rather than be divided by if we keep working at it. That's a good question.
Make sense?
Okay. Thanks.